Deflategate. Mm-hmm. That's still in the headlines, huh?
Yeah, Tom Brady is taking on Roger Goodell. Today it begins, Dan.
All right.
And of course, we have so much news that I wish I could offer you in baseball. And a lot of headlines that include an amazing run that Albert Pujols is on. He hit 2 home runs yesterday in an Angels victory and has launched 12 long balls in the month of June alone. But instead, the news coming from baseball is very disappointing. Previously sealed court documents were released to the public that revealed Pete Rose gambled on baseball while he was a player for the Cincinnati Reds. Now, Rose, one of baseball's greatest hitters ever, was banned for life after a 1989 investigation demonstrated he gambled on baseball. Then for the next 15 years, he denied any wrongdoing at all. And then in a tell-all interview, because he had a book to sell, he, quote, came clean and admitted to gambling on baseball, but only as a manager. Now, these documents, which are copies of a notebook his bookie kept, were previously sealed under court order for the past 26 years as part of a mail fraud investigation. They had nothing to do with Major League Baseball. And these pages prove that Rose was placing bets, even on his own team, as a player. Now, there are no records to indicate that he bet against his team, but that's likely irrelevant to baseball's new commissioner, Rob Manfred, who is currently considering an application to reinstate Rose, because Rose filed to be reinstated all back in April. That's highly unlikely now. Rose, through his attorney, released this statement, quote, since we submitted the application earlier this year, we committed to MLB that we would not comment on specific matters relating to reinstatement. I need to maintain that. To be sure, though, I'm eager to sit down with Manfred to address my entire history, the good and the bad, and my long personal journey since baseball. Therefore, at this point, it is not appropriate for me to comment on any specifics. AKA deny, deny, deny. More with that. And Tom Brady, he's been denying that he had any wrongdoing in the Deflategate scandal. Well, NFL didn't buy it. Ted Wells didn't buy it, suspended him for 4 games. And today the appeal will be heard. Should he have his suspension reduced is a big question. But Brady went full court press and is looking to be entirely exonerated. Interestingly enough, Ted Wells, the man who conducted the investigation into the Patriots and Tom Brady, he will be present to be questioned. Of course, we'll bring you the update on that. It could be a couple days. It could be a couple weeks. We don't know the timetable yet on that decision to be made. That's it for sports, brought to you by Legal Docs, by me.
All right.
Cheaters and liars, Dan, it's too bad.
No comment there. 44 minutes past the hour. I'm just going to leave it. Just going to leave that one. Coming up, more storms tear across the heartland of our country. We're going to tell you where people are cleaning up from flooding.